What's up, Dubspot? My name is Adam Partridge. I produce under the name of Atropolis, and I'm an instructor here at Dubspot. Today, we're going to be getting into a tutorial that builds a kind of an advanced instrument rack that's used for trap music that uses an instrument rack, sampler, drum rack, and an arpeggiator. I built it so it works primarily with two octaves, because I feel like that's what a lot of producers are working with these days. Trap music originates in the United States, specifically the South, and has been recently breaking into new boundaries by mixing with other electronic forms of music. So I'm just gonna quickly demonstrate what's going on here. We got our kicks, which is nice, so when we, you know, wanna change it, we can. Got some different snares. And if we want to tune those snares, we can do that by turning this knob. And then what I really like about this kit is the sequenced hi-hats that we have. This tutorial is downloadable. You'll be able to see the different sections. And if you ever get lost during the video, I provided notes that you can see. Once you access the info view in the bottom left, you pop that open. And you'll see when you put your mouse over the different steps, it provides notes to assist you through the different steps of this tutorial. The first part of constructing this drum kit is focusing on the kick. I'm gonna first start by dropping an instrument rack into this MIDI track called Build Kit. And I'm gonna put a sampler inside of this instrument rack. The next thing I'm gonna do is rename the sampler to kicks by hitting Command R, and I'm gonna call it kicks, and then I'm gonna click on the sampler, hit Command R again, and rename it kicks. A part of the tutorial is a file called Lex Luger. I need you to access those files, so wherever you download it onto your desktop, you need to find it. And you're gonna do that by going into the browser view and to any one of those three folders. I'm going to go to the Lex Drums inside of the Lex Luger kit, and I'm going to pop open my zones right over here, which is in my sampler, and I'm going to drag and drop those kicks into my zones. Once I drop the kicks into my sampler, I want to go ahead and access my Filter Global tab, and in the bottom right you'll see Voices. I want to change this to 1, and by doing this it's going to help reduce any bleed over you might get if you have long releases. Now we're gonna wanna map these drums so I can access each individual kick by the turn of a macro knob. And we're gonna do this in the selector tab. In order to do this properly, we're gonna have to crop this by hand. So I'm gonna go ahead and select all the kicks by hitting Command A and clicking and dragging from right to left to minimize the range of these samples. The next step is I'm going to drag each individual kick out, as you can see, just like this. It's kind of tedious, but it's worth the extra time. Once that's done, I want to now map this selector, which will scroll through the different samples, to a macro knob. So I'm going to right-click in this area and map to macro 1. A macro knob allows you to map multiple parameters of audio effects, MIDI effects, or any of Ableton's devices, as well as VSTs. The next step is to rename that macro by hitting Command R and calling it Kick SEL. I want to be able to change the articulation of this kick, so I'm going to go into the Filter Global tab and also map the release of these kicks to the macro 2. So I'm going to right-click on the release of my amplitude envelope and map to macro 2. I'm also going to rename that macro kick release. Right now, we mapped this kick selector to the macro knob. And as you can see, the range is a little too large. It goes from 0 to 127. I want to modify it so it goes to 0 to 6, because I only have 6 samples inside of my sampler right now. And I want to make sure I can access each of those with ease. So I'm going to go into the map mode to change that. And as you can see, the kick selector ranges from 0 to 127. I can just simply type in 6. It's that simple. And once I go back by clicking the map mode, you'll see that it's limited to 0 to 6. Finally, in the instrument rack, I'm going to go into the key tab, which allows me to map the range of these samples in relationship to my keyboard. As you can see, I can play all these samples ranging from the lowest octave to the highest octave. I want to change that. I want to modify it so it stretches from C2 to C3. So you just simply click and drag. So now you should be able to hear your different kicks when you move that selector knob. In this case, articulation determines the length of the sound, whether it's short or long. You'll see that you can play the different tuned kicks. Part two is building the snare aspect of this kit, and it's very similar to part one. I'm gonna go back into my build kit, and I'm gonna drop another sampler into my instrument rack, and I'm gonna drop it right underneath where it says kicks, and I'm gonna go ahead and rename this snares command R, and I'm also gonna rename that sampler snares as well. The next part is we're gonna go into the folder where the Lex Luger samples are found, and I'm gonna go into first the Lex snares, and I'm gonna drag and drop all of those snares into my zones of the sampler we just dropped into the instrument rack. I'm also gonna go into the Lex claps and drop all those claps into the zones as well. Once we get all these samples inside of our sampler, I wanna then map them out to my selector. And we're gonna have to do this by hand again. And like we did with the kick, we're gonna right click over here on the selector to map it to macro 3. I'm gonna go ahead and rename that macro snare SEL. And like before, I have a smaller range, so I want to modify the selector range. And as you guys can see, we only have 14 samples in here. So I'm going to go into that map mode and change the range from 0 to 127 to 0 to 14. And now that knob, when we turn it, will access each of those individual snares. I also want to be able to tune these snares. So I'm going to go into my pitch oscillation tab and turn on my pitch envelope. And I'm going to set the amount to 24 semitones. You can change it to however you want, but I recommend working with 24. And I want to move the peak. I want to be able to move that peak using a macro knob. And this is going to change the tuning of our snares. So I'm going to right click on the peak of my pitch envelope and map it to macro 4. And I'm going to rename macro 4 now, snare tune. The last step is modifying the range of the snare within my instrument rack. And as you can see, it is ranging from the lowest octave to the highest octave. And again, I'm in the key tab of my instrument rack. So I want to change that so the snare ranges from C sharp 3 to G sharp 3. So now, when I play the snare, you're going to see I can kind of change the tuning of the snare. I'm going to actually go to the snare tune to make it a little bit higher. So I have that ability to change my snares. I can also, if I want to just play one snare, I can move the snare tune macro knob. If you want to automate that parameter, and if you want to change the different snare sounds and claps, you can move the macro knob labeled snare select. Drum programming is covered more extensively in our Ableton Live course at Dubspot in level 2 and 3 here in New York and online. Stay tuned for part 3, building the hi-hats.
Welcome to Dubspot. We believe in providing you hands-on experience right away. Whether you're completely new to music and want to turn the sounds in your head into a musical reality, or you're an experienced artist looking to refine your skills and add new tools to your arsenal, we're ready to meet you at your level. For students of all ages, all levels, and all styles of music, Dubspot is here to help you achieve your goals. With course offerings both online, wherever you are, and at our school in the heart of New York City, we are ready to guide you through the next phase of your musical transformation. Whether you want to produce music, DJ, or do both, you've come to the right place. Come explore Dubspot for yourself. become a part of our community, and make music.